Can we get a bell here? Let me see. Yeah, let's get the bell going. The cup. Wow. I'm going to start out this video in a very iconoclastic way because I have a very iconoclastic presence here, and I value that. I recognize it and value it just as I've valued other iconoclastic people in my life in this world, because when they're gone, you really, really, really miss them. It's quite rare. There's not many who just have this 360 degree. They're not robotic. Okay, they're just not robotic. They're not afraid to just put it out there 360 degrees. So at least I value it, which means I keep going. This keeps me going. It's valuable to me just to experience it. I say, I wow myself. I say, wow, I like this. This is good. Okay, so this is what keeps it going. I will adjust this. It went down too much, didn't it? Wow. Can we get a little light here? Can we get a light at the end of the tunnel there? Something like that. Okay, very great. Welcome to the video, everyone. It's Friday. I'm in a good mood. I just hammered. I just crushed a workout. Just crushed it. 3,000 stairs running up and down. 1,500 up, 1,500 down for a half hour straight. And I got the endorphins are just like flowing like crazy, I think. Tomorrow, I probably will have, it'll be a different story, won't it? But I'm just enjoying it right now because that was pretty cool. That's the first time I've been able to do that on the heels of a 2.5 hour hike several days earlier that just wiped me out. Absolutely. My legs, I could hardly stand actually. I almost fell down. I said, whoa, just, you know, it was amazing. So bouncing back strong here, activated myself here. I may have 1 month and I'm going to show you something here before you click on something, right? Okay, let's see if I can get this going. There you go. Beautiful. I actually did some graphic work for this. I'm going to try to do a little more on that. It takes a lot of extra work, believe it or not. All sorts of programs, all sorts of computer slowdowns, problems, crashes, this, and that. But I said, okay, this is important. I'm going to talk about pivot points for us. Pivot points. Now, this video, as all I try to make it 360 degree experience for you. It's iconoclastic. Everything I do is iconoclastic. I'm a completely iconoclastic being in a positive way. And I always say it with some humor, with some, you know, grace and not mean-spirited. I mean, if something's not right, I'll say it's not right. Like Terence McKenna said, you know, dump your gurus into and pick up plants. And I said, Terence, that's that's a wayward statement. It's a wayward statement, okay? Love you, but that's a wayward statement. No. Drop the plants and pick up the gurus, okay? So something like that. I mean, I'll speak up. I'm not afraid to speak up to anyone. Once that's gone, it doesn't come back. It's not replaced. This culture is becoming extremely robotic and very much dictatorship oriented. Just the structure of their mind requires a dictatorship, actually. And you can't have these iconoclastic beings just saying, you know, just saying, the court jester just says what needs to be said here. Now, so we'll go back to those pivot points here. We had one on July 24th, 2016. It is now August 5th. 2016. July 24th was the key pivot point. By a pivot point, I mean that you have to get past that point with some momentum, with gas in your tank. You can't be wiped out by it. And from July 24th, then that started the last week of July. And the last week of July was designed to really crush us very badly, psycho-spiritual way. I had a very difficult time, actually. And I was able to, you know, get them bouncing back now by the 5th. But it was really, really quite rough. So we're headed for another pivot point, which is September 6th. This is what, at the Wowchella convention, this is what I was told very directly, extremely directly, September 6th, 2016. It's another pivot point where those who want to control us are going to make another strategic, psycho-spiritual move, so to speak. They're very clever. There's like a matador who, keeps enticing the bull to charge, and then they, use the little spears and poof, and gradually, another spear. The bull gradually just collapses. This is what they're trying to do. They're trying to collapse us all, collapse our spiritual will. And they're doing it step by step by step by step by step. So these pivot points are points where they're trying to collapse our spiritual will, stick another spear in the bull, so to speak. So it's very important that we get through these pivot points with some momentum and speed, because we don't want to stall out. So I didn't stall out during this last pivot point, and hopefully you didn't either. If you are, let's get going again. So we need to crush this month. We have 1 month now to really crush it and get tremendous momentum going towards September 6th. Okay, tremendous momentum. So this is what we'll do. We'll crush it. So I just crushed that workout today. I crushed the mountain workout also earlier. I mean, this stuff, forget about the gym. You come on out and crush this workout with me, and then you'll find out how you what it's all about. the gym is great. The gym is great. But this one tests your resolve, to say the least. And I just look at it, I'm just absolutely says, I have to do this. I just have to do this. I am going to do this. It's do or die, sort of. When I'm facing that final run, I'm just saying, this is going to happen. That's all there is to it. And I'm going to make it happen. And you just mentally, stay mentally strong, mentally tough. So we have this 1 month period to crush it before the next pivotal point, the very pivotal point in history, really, as those who really want to institute global control over us and turn us into a robotic society, actually, they're going to make another move, another push, psycho-spiritually. It can be subtle, it can be overt, but you will feel it. I certainly felt the last one very, very strongly. Everything tightened up, didn't it? Everything psycho-spiritually tightened up on us. And if you're very iconoclastic, you feel it. But if you're already robotic, you say, oh, yeah, this feels kind of normal, feels kind of safe, it's not so threatening to me, I'm getting even more robotic, oh, that's great. But for me, no. So I had trouble, moving over the last week or so, as far as just I felt like a zombie almost, Then today I finally busted out of it. And I was just coming home. My Beach Boys CD, it vanished on the trip. It just vanished. And it's in the car. I didn't take it out. I didn't know anything. I knew where it was, and it's just gone. I can't find it anywhere. This is really extraordinary. Well, I said, what do I got? I've just been writing without any music, no singing. And I said, wait a minute. I've got George Jones. Let me put on George Jones. And put George Jones on, and I started singing along, and I haven't sung for about a week or so. And I was like singing great. I was right with him. I said, hey, this is fun. This is great. And then he got to a song called She's Mine. And it started in, and I just stopped. I said, uh-oh. He's broken out his Rolls Royce voice. And I just backed off, and I just listened to it. I didn't sing. I didn't try. I said, hey, he shifted into a higher gear right here, and I can't touch this. I cannot, and so I'm not going to even try. Not going to even try, man. Let's just listen. Wow. It just floored me. It just floored me, and I was in tears. It just broke me down. I've been in my vehicle, and it's got a good sound system, and you can tune it the way you want it, and it's reverberating in there, and it just sounds great. If you listen on headphones on YouTube, it doesn't sound nearly as great. Okay, this is off the CDs direct. Man, oh man, oh man. I felt like one of those Texas oil barons in a honky-tonk down in Dallas, Texas, or Houston, Texas, and George Jones would be singing in there, and they would just be crying in their beer, or their whiskey, whatever. Just just broke him down. And he just broke me down. He absolutely broke me down. And then I said, maybe I'll bounce back on the next song. No, this is, the next song was, I'll Share My World With You. And it was kind of an alternative version he has a number of versions of these songs. And this one was just fabulous. And just, again, I didn't even try. Can't touch that. So, you know when you're in a situation where you can't touch that. Okay, you know it. And what do? You sit down, you're quiet, and you just appreciate it, okay? And here's a great example. It doesn't get any better. Sri Sri Anandamayi, it does not get any better than this, okay? Let's keep our efforts going. I say, because we had this guru here, and it doesn't get any better. You will not ever find anything that gets any better than this, okay? And she was here, this guru was here in this world from 1896 to 1982. And I remember in 1997 when I found out about exactly who it was that had been kind of spiritually in my life, but I didn't know who it was. I found out, oh, so this is who it was. And to my dismay, I didn't discover this for a little while. Then I discovered that she had, wasn't here anymore physically, apparently. I'll talk about that more about that later. And it just about killed me. It really did. I was just completely distraught. To miss a guru that it doesn't get any better than that. To miss that, I just couldn't get over it. And you know what? The amazing thing is, you want to talk about a great guru, she started visiting me in dreams because she knew I was so distraught. And she goes, look, you didn't see me when I was here, but I'm still here. I've had many, many, many visits with her in dreams. Literally, she's there and I'm interacting and she's mostly talking. I'm just sitting listening, basically. And I can't say anything hardly. And just like this picture of just like this, like you're talking to someone like this is talking with you. And I'm just, wow. So you talk about a great guru, does this for you. They realize that you're distraught, that you miss them, and so they come to you anyway. See, because it's no barrier to them, the fact that their body may be, their bones may be encased in rock salt and kankal, but their spirit is as free as a bird. And they can come to you in dreams, or they can appear to you actually as a vision or bodily, they can appear to you. And they will, if that's what it takes. They'll do whatever it takes. So I was just super blessed by that. And it's helped me out a little bit, although I'm still regret very much that I wasn't able to get over to India. I tried in 1975. I was so sick I couldn't make it. I knew there was something there, but wasn't sure what, and something was calling me there. But so I still have some regrets over that. How can you not? It's still it still hurts a lot. But bringing this up about how I've had visitations by quite a few great gurus, because I said, man, Brahman, I missed you. I mean, it's so terrible. And he showed up in a dream, and that was extremely profound. Miss Longchenpa, he's shown up a number of times, and these various Jamyan Khyentse Jogi Lodo has shown up, and Jesus has shown up many times, so I get to experience them, even though they're not physically at present in the world. I still get to experience exactly as they were in this world, exactly this way. And you get to really experience how they really are, which is super, super helpful. But what I say with Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma is I say, let's keep our efforts going. We've got to build on the momentum of this. We cannot let her down. We cannot let this situation slip through our fingers. I've been trying for now almost 20 years to alert people to this situation. I say, people, we cannot let this slip through our fingers. And you know what? Most everyone is letting it slip through their fingers. This is a catastrophe for us. it's foolish beyond measure. When you get an appearance that's as good as it gets, doesn't get any better than this, not in any universe, not in any place, any realm, never will you find something better than this. And you let that slip through your fingers, there's something severely wrong with you and with the culture. Okay, really catastrophically wrong to not recognize. Asleep at the wheel. Jesus has been back for like 15 months, and the Vatican hasn't said a word. Protestant churches haven't said a word. Christendom hasn't said a word about it. They're asleep at the wheel. This is incredible. And Jesus is just saying, okay, you know, let's see what happens here. And who's awake? Who's awake and who's asleep at the wheel? And they are absolutely asleep at the wheel. So this is how far our culture has fallen. I mean, we're letting this solid gold just, you know, fumbling it away. So I suggest make every day Guru Purnima, if that's how you pronounce it, Guru Purnima, something like that. Make every day the celebration of the Guru right now. Why do we have to have just one day of the year? Right now, we're in an extreme emergency crisis in the world, a psycho-spiritual crisis, the worst that's ever been on this planet, or pretty much any planet anywhere. That's how bad it is. Why not every day let's start hammering, you know, the Gurus and say, you know, we're celebrating you today. Every day we're celebrating you. For the next 3 months or so, we're going to celebrate you every single day. Every single day is Guru Purnima for us. Okay, now the Indians might say, no, we have this day set aside. And I said, well, you know, I'm just a stupid American. I don't know better. You know, sorry. So, we're going to do it every day. So you see Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, and you just be quiet. Like, okay, can't touch this. Just like hearing that Jones song, can't touch this one. Not gonna even try. So that, you know, we may be doing our best to be spiritual, etc. But when you come across this, you just say, hey, this is the Rolls Royce, you know. This is a Rolls Royce right here. And this is a different gear altogether. And I don't have that gear yet. So I'm just going to be quiet and just acknowledge it. And hey. It was a great experience hearing Jones break out that voice, and I, you know, immediately I realized, can't touch this. I can't touch it. So don't even try. Don't even try. It's a great experience because it's a knockout blow. I love to be knocked out positively. Just, you got to love it, right? Just be knocked out by this fabulous, 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 fabulous guru who, if I even start to think of her, I get choked up and can't even speak. That's the problem. She's so fabulous that nobody can even say anything about it. That's the truth. That is the truth. Now, what she told us, I started this day talking about this situation, and she told us very adamantly and clearly how we should look at her, and she says, look at me as your sister. Okay, as your sister. Now, sometimes, our sisters help the mother take care of a baby or something, right? The sisters can be very good at that. They can babysit, they can do this, they act like the mother sometimes, surrogate mother. Okay, and so she acted like a spiritual mother to us, overlooking our spiritual path and helping us out and all this. So people call her, you know, Ma, means spiritual mother. Not flesh and blood mother, spiritual mother. But she asked us very, very, very strongly to see her as our sister. Or if we must, a friend, okay? Or as a little child, our little daughter, little tiny daughter, if you want to put her in the context in that way. But look at, she said, look at me as your sister. And sometimes your sister functions as a mother, okay? But she's still your sister. See, and this is the greatness of Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, is she seemed to function like a mother figure, but really all along, she's your sister. So we all have this spiritual sister in common. Actually, this is something we should all take this to heart, that in our spiritual family, we have this sister. This is our sister. You know, we're related like a family to her completely, as if same way as if you know, similar, but even more strongly than we're related to like our sister, our brother, our siblings. She's a spiritual sibling. She's our sister. And this is how she wants us to look at her, because it prevents this distancing thing about a mother and a child, that you want to avoid that. And she told us, avoid that at all costs. Do not get into that. It creates a spiritual problems, actually. But that doesn't mean those who say Ma are wrong, because they're saying, you know, they're acknowledging her role, like a mother looks after her children really carefully. Well, she does that, right? So that's what they're talking about. But don't make the mistake of thinking, you know, that don't try to turn it towards she's your sister. And your sister can just, you know, just have this feeling like, you know, just my sister's here. And it gives you a really good feeling. A very different feeling than if your mother was here, doesn't it? Mother tends to infantize you. Sister does not. Sister raises you up and says, look, you know, what I am, you are also this. You are also this. You're just pretending to forget what you really are. And this is what we're doing here. So we're speaking in this 360 degree wowness. And when you see a guru like that, it's just 360 degree wowness right there. And you just wow it. Okay? Just wow it. And the more aware you are, the easier it is to do this. It's just like singing. I could sing with just about anyone. I can stay with them. Throughout my life, I've been singing for maybe 40 years or so. I wanted to be a singer, actually, for a while. My uncle was a singer, an opera singer, understudied to the stars of the San Francisco Opera Company, which was a major opera company. And I wanted to be a singer. My iconoclastic attitude was very, very much helped me in this way. So I'm aware of voices and singing. So when Jones starts singing that song, my jaw drops. I immediately recognize that. I can't touch that. Just let it alone. Let it alone. Just appreciate it. Just appreciate it. And if you're a real singer, you know, you can tell. You can just tell. Just too good. It's just too good. Same thing if you're aficionado of gurus and saints, etc. When you see a real, you know, Dharma king, you know, it's just can't touch that. Just be knocked out by it. Just allow yourself to be knocked out by it, like I was by Jones. Just broke me down in tears. I just let myself be knocked out by it. What a song. She's Mine, it's called. On YouTube, it doesn't sound as good because it just didn't have the resonance of it. But, man. So let yourself be knocked out. You know, this is the thing. This is so helpful. We're not in competition with anyone, okay? We're just going all out to evaporate our continuity fear. Is all we're doing. And so, don't think you have to compete with somebody. Just let yourself be knocked out. This is what you should be doing, is find something that just knocks you out. Not that you can say, oh yeah, I can do that. I can sing along with that. You know, that's fine. That's good. But try, hopefully you'll come across something that just likes, oh, okay, let me just feel how it feels to be just knocked out by something superlative. And rest. Rest. Don't try to do anything about it. Don't try to do anything about it. It's just there. Just like ourself is here right now, already intrinsically awake. See, mind is intrinsically awake. It's not anything we have to awaken at all. we're just searching for this ourselves. It's completely absurd. And I went through a whole recognition this morning of that. And it was very, extremely profound. So just let that be. Just wow. Wow, 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 wow. There's non-dualism, then there's wowish non-dualism. I got to the wowish non-dualism this morning. So we really, really want to crush this month like some intense workout and show them what it's all about. So when this next pivotal point comes up, we'll be able to cruise right on through it and make it through strong into the September push, right? And as we know, I know there are people from all over the world watching these videos, but in the United States we have this election, this crucial election, November 2nd, and as many realize, it's a disaster no matter what happens. We're in big trouble no matter what happens. Really big trouble. And it's like a train wreck. You can see it coming from a long, long ways away. All right, I'm going to bring it down a little bit here. Bring down the contrast. Let me see what happens here. I'll bring this up. And wow. Okay. I'll get it dialed in here. So we're just in terrible trouble here, and you got to see it ahead of time and realize, oh boy, you know, we're just going to get KO'd here, really knocked out in a bad way. You don't, it's the kind of knockout you don't want to have. Okay. And I could say a lot about it. I could say a lot about it, actually. But maybe we won't. Maybe we won't say any much about it. Right? Maybe yes, maybe no. But it's going to have a domino effect on the entire world. The pivot, the November 2nd is so pivotal, it's ridiculous. So we have to just be powered through that and have a way to power through that. And I don't see anybody really having a way. I put up Zog Champa for president. We need some genius involvement, an idea of how to power through this situation in the world. Even though you're not an American, believe me, this is going to have total ramifications for history. Total ramifications. If martial law is not declared first, okay, which would keep the Barry in office. And for me, you take all the presidents in history and all, you know, all the bad stuff they did, he's worse than all presidents put together. His 8 years he's done more damage to this country than all the damage that's been done by all presidents before him put together. Psycho-spiritual damage has just been, he's just the most destructive president ever by magnitude, almost immeasurable magnitude, and he set everything up for this very bad collapse. That was his purpose. That's his purpose. So, as much as I feel Hillary Clinton is a complete disaster, I'd much rather have her in office than Barry declaring martial law and staying in. I'd much rather have the Clintons in office than Barry O continuing on. That's how bad it's been. And people think it's just great. It's great. Oh, no. This wonderful guy, the greatest thing. I mean, wow. They must really like to be spiritually discouraged and love the collapse and how, you know, it's just astonishing. Just astonishing. So hopefully there's not martial law, but there's a good chance it could happen, actually. So that's something I just like, wow. That's so we got to have our options open. As I've said, if Clinton, the Clintons are in office, we're guaranteed that we're going to go communistic in this country. It might be a soft landing, but we will land there, and freedoms will be over with in this country. Okay. if, and for the world, actually. If Trump wins, it's going to be chaos because the blacks will burn down the cities and the Hispanics will burn down the countryside, actually. This is what the Holy Spirit showed me. And they've been set up for that by Barry O, okay, to feel that they're entitled to break the law and that the police are the bad guys, and that if something goes wrong they don't like, they're entitled to burn down a city, you know, or do whatever they want to do. It's, well, we understand, you know, it's obviously so terrible, you know, your feelings are hurt, you know, this. There's no law and order. He's the man of lawlessness. He's the Antichrist, Barry O. And he set it all up for chaos. If Trump wins, there's going to be civil disobedience and criminality on a scale we've never seen before in this country. Just trashing, you know, trashing the country. The Hispanics will set fire to the forest. They'll set fire to the countryside. They'll just be become arsonists. Arson will be encouraged by the rabble-rousers. There's many rabble-rousers. There's no more respect for law and order. And it's custom set up for a severe crisis in this country, actually. Totally set up by Barry O. And what a guy, huh? So we have to be ready for this. You know, it's possible that Trump could win, and then, you know, chaos is going to break out. And Barry O used that as a pretext to declare martial law, actually, and stay in office, put the Constitution on hold. And the people will say, "Oh yeah, 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 you're so great, you're so..." No, 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 no. I'd absolutely choose Hillary and the Clintons over him any day. Right this moment, I'll take that swap. As bad as they are, as sleazy as they are, as just, I mean, they're just horrible. And yet, you know, they're not nearly in as low as Barry O. Bill has a little, you know, he's my same birthday, so he's got a little something. I can't give it, you know, he's not quite over the edge, you know, entirely. So very corrupt. Arkansas was the most corrupt state in the Union when he was governor. It was just the Iran-Contra thing. I mean, or Nicaragua, the Nicaragua thing, guns for, you know, Sandinistas or whatever. Just, everything was so corrupt, and they're just horrible. Yet, you know, it's just, we might be able to survive a little bit for a little while, but we'll certainly lose our freedoms. No question about it. They're almost all gone anyway. So for an iconoclastic being like myself, that's disaster. It's disaster for me. Already I can't do like 99% of what I'd like to do in terms of just being a free spirit and encouraging people to also break out of their roboticism. I can't do it. Be arrested. People will say, "You're crazy. You can't do that. Come on. We're trying to be good little robots here." So, so I don't do it. That's okay. That's okay. So we better have our options lined up. Okay. So we got to really crush it. We need something really profound, and it will happen. It will happen, where we have to just align with this. And it's like you know, something shows up, and you realize, wow, this is a higher gear here. And so, this is what we're gonna do. This is what we're gonna go for. It's like listening to that song by Joe. She might have said, "I'm not gonna listen to anybody else right now." Are you kidding me? If somebody else said, "Hey, listen to this," all right, no, shh, quiet. I'm not going to listen to some other song. I mean, this is it. He's just absolutely crushing it. Totally. And you just sit there and just say, wow. So that's how you crush it. From the top. That's how you juice it. Okay. Someday maybe, man, but not now. Not right now. I'd have to find another gear for that one. Either that or drink a couple quarts of whiskey. I don't know what he was drinking, but he was pretty relaxed and just velvet, you know, just had the pipes, had everything. So you have to be truly relaxed, and the key to relaxation is realize we're already relaxed. The self is already naturally relaxed. So there's nothing we need to relax, actually. There's only two feelings we can have, the feeling of difficulty and the feeling of ease. That's it. So we're either feeling difficulty or feeling ease. When we're searching for ourselves, we're feeling difficulty. When we realize we don't need to search for ourselves, we feel ease. It's really that simple. And this ease is not an easement. It's a natural ease. There's nothing, we don't need to ease anything. We don't need to relax into anything. We don't need to dive into the ocean. There's no diver into the ocean. We are the ocean. So the I is just to search the self, searching for itself. That's all. Does the fact that self is searching for itself, does that mean the self is lost? Not at all. It means it's whimsical. It means it's engaging in absurdity. So the ocean doesn't need anything to dive into it to be the ocean. It doesn't need to be found. We don't need to be found. There's nothing outside of us to find us anyway. So the I doesn't really exist. There's no independent I searching for us. It's our own search, spirit search for itself, which is completely unnecessary, and is just a way of trying to forget what it is. That's all that's going on. So this is the heart of non-duality. There's nothing diving into the ocean. There's nothing relaxing into the self. There's no easement. There's nothing finding the self. There's no attainment of the self. It's when you realize, you drop all that, as Punjaji said, call off the search. It's when you call off the search, there you are. That's the heart of non-dualism, call off the search. Punjaji was a very good teacher. He's a guru, very good guru. As far as what he says, it's just, you know, wow. Some very, very well expressed, and you just call off the search. That's the heart of it. It's that simple, isn't it? You stop searching for yourself. And this will happen. This will happen. For sure it will happen. So get ready for it to happen. Does it happen to an I? No. Who does it happen to? Nothing happens to the self. It's just the self realizes it. Just, oh, I am. This is what I am. It's not like something extraneous happened or anything. No, it just stops searching. And then you become naturally aware of natural awareness. Of pristine, clear, pure awareness, intrinsic spaciousness. I am that. You know, this is without doing anything, and there's just as ease because you're not struggling to find yourself, right? So no more feeling of difficulty. It's gone. The feeling of difficulty vanishes. Totally vanishes. Just like the rope and not the snake. The notion of a snake is just gone. The notion of needing to make effort is just gone. And you realize it never was needed at all. So you don't need to remember it. So what did we do? How did I get here? There's no getting to where we already are. So now we're, you know, talking non-dual talk, which is part of the 360 degreeness. But we always want to keep it in this 360 degree wowness. Because the question still is, well, we need to accept this, you know, accept and drop the search, yeah. And once this, abide in this, you know, drop the searchness. There's no more search going on for what we are. So we have to be very adept at this wowness. Just go quiet. Don't even think about messing with it. Just like listen to Jones, I didn't even think about saying, I said, no. Don't even think about it. Just listen. Just hear it. So when we get this clarity, when clarity arises within you, just wow it. Don't try to say, hey, I just found some clarity. There is no I. there's an imaginary I searching for the self, but there's not a real I at all. There's no real search taking place at all. There's no extraneous search taking place at all. There's nothing to get. Just drop the search and that's it. There's nothing else. There's nothing to get about the search at all. We're just searching for what we are. We already are what we are. We already are where we are. Trying to find where we are, just stop searching and we say, well, we experience the ease of being what we are. It's that simple. I did a complete workout today. Lifting weights of the upper body, core work, abs and core work, and then the legs. So just a total Friday thing, man, just because I'll rest Saturday, or not. So keep it going right now. Keep it going. Keep it going. Keep the hammers in the Sargodhara Maharaj going, for instance. Those are really good, great hammers. We have some great gurus helping us out here. Sagara Maharaj, Punjaji is a great one. Then we have, of course, Ramana Maharshi, Sri Sri Anandamaya Ma. You know, we have these gurus in the house. And, of course, we have Padmasambhava, Longchenpa, Jamyang Kenshi Choki Lodro, and other Nyingma masters. And we just have unbelievable help right now. So letting that go to waste is just an atrocity in terms of laziness. We cannot be lazy right now. This is an atrocity. You should view it as an atrocity. A disgrace. You know, beyond killing yourself, don't kill yourself. Just decide, I'm not going to do it anymore. I'm going to get with it. It's such a disgrace. You have to fix it. You just decide, I got to do this. Even it means making a U-turn. This happened to me today. I had to make a U-turn, go back, and said, no, I'm going to work out. I'm going to do it. I was in the lane where I was going to miss it. I said, well, maybe I'll do it tomorrow. And then something told me, no. Holy Spirit wants it today. I said, wow. Holy cow. I don't know if I can handle it. Well, I did. I really did. And now I'm crushing this, you know, smoothie, which is a lemonade, a whole apple, and a whole bunch of pineapple. A lot of fiber. So, 360 degrees here. Here's what we do. We don't just sit here and say, well, who's asking the question? Okay? Well, that's very hip. And there's nothing wrong with that. But we're 360 degrees here in the wow of what we're doing. We have probably the best constellation of gurus in this last century, the best constellation of gurus that have ever been in this planet. Okay. How can we let that go to waste? So we just have to stick with it, and I got to invite more people to the Take Satsang on Facebook Take Satsang, and like the page, and I'm going to try to help you just start hammering it. Don't miss this opportunity. In one way or another, you have to crush this next month, and then go on from there, and keep your momentum going past November 2nd and through the end of this year and into next year. You have to keep it going. And you have to have good habits. And so the idea of, I can't do it, no. That's not an idea at all. You just have to absolutely say, that's no idea at all. I will not let these gurus down. They didn't let me down. I'm not going to let them down. Plain and simple. Okay? It's like that. they don't want you to fail. They want you to succeed, so don't let them down. They trust in our success. They expect our success. So, I don't know. I'm just got to keep expanding the Facebook. I lack confidence, and I'm trying to generate stuff that people will like. It's very difficult. People are very much into clicks as far as what they pay attention to, etc. It's not easy. But I will keep trying to just lay a lot of content on Take Satsang. I have a number of pages. That's one, Take Satsang. Facebook.com/Take Satsang. SATSANG. And like the page so it shows up in your feed, and visit it and just go through it. Go through all the various stuff that's there. And I'm trying to just, wow, keep the wow going. But, and you can share also there. I believe it's possible to share. And if there's something that just doesn't fit, I'll take it off if that's possible. I think it might be. I don't know if I'm a ministry, if I can do that or not. No animal pictures and not too many nature pictures. It's okay to use nature as a backdrop for photos and things like that, or there's some, it's a little wiggle room there, but no pictures of just regular people, if you can help that, really. Keep it on the gurus. Keep it on the gurus. They're the ones that have this extra gear. It now is time to listen to the singers who can really sing the song. And I think that's maybe what the Holy Spirit was telling me. Now it's time to listen to Jones. I was singing with the Beach Boys and really hammering it out really good. I said, wow, I can really do this. And then it says, okay, now go listen to Jones. Can he really do that? And I said, no. So it's the Holy Spirit saying, listen to the best now. Okay, listen to the best right at this point in time. This will get you through. So let's listen to the best gurus. Let's pay attention to the best gurus. I know there's some gurus in the world. God bless them. I love these gurus. Okay. But let's listen to the best right now. This is how I look at it. You're looking at Ramana, Sri Sri Nandamaya, Ma, etc. Doesn't get any better. Doesn't get any better. So they have that extra gear, don't they? They do. There's a lot of good singers in the world, and then there's George Jones. And this is just true. Those who listen know it. They know it. And so there may be some gurus around, and they're helpful. But right now, listen to the best. Listen to the best. Pay attention to the best. Okay, so I need to get in there and just start going for it, And I include Poonja G in there. I'm going to include him because he's, I love Poonja G. A lot of us do. I wasn't into him when all the others were into him. Ganja G and Muji and all the various disciples. He has many, many, many disciples that have spun off from him. But he is very helpful. So is Nisargadatta Maharaj. Very, very helpful. They relate to Westerners. They help bring it to Westerners. So, they're in the building. They're really in the building. Hammers of Nisargadatta Maharaj is just very, very helpful. But Sri Sri Nandamaya Ma is a different story. She comes, when she enters the building, you just go silent. That's it. Your mind just stops. That's the only appropriate reaction. Your mind just stops. Doesn't have to say a word. Just know it instantly. Like that. Just no doubt. First I saw her, I just went, knocked my mind right out. Just stopped thinking. My mind just went quiet and just instantly. Just, it was just poof, like a force field hit me or something. As in a video. I didn't have to think. It was just completely obvious to my spirit. My spirit just said, wow. And that's it. Didn't say anything else. I just went into this, maybe the most intense wow of my life. It was the most intense wow of my life. And it hasn't stopped, actually. You can't get rid of that wow, actually. And the only way to deal with that is to just be to accept that it's permanent. And that the self is all naturally awake. It's always awake. Buddha mind is inherently Buddha mind. It's awake Buddha mind. Okay, Buddha mind is awake Buddha mind. There's no such thing as non-awake Buddha mind. Non-awake Buddha mind doesn't exist. Never has. It's always awake. That's what it is. It's wakefulness. It's intrinsic wakefulness. And when we come across this intrinsic wakefulness in this way, that's, we recognize and our mind stops and we're just quiet. And this is very appropriate. Anything we say is missing it. Anything we say is missing it. Man, listening to Jones is like drinking chocolate milkshakes. Hey, the Holy Spirit say, time to drink your, you know, chocolate milkshake with vanilla ice cream floating on it. A chocolate vanilla ice cream float. Oh, man. Wow. It's just rich. It's just so rich. You think, can I handle this richness? So are the Beach Boys, but Jones seems to bring it home, you know, to this ultimate extent. Man. So it's time for the aficionados to bring out the, you know, their best bottles of port, the 500-year-old bottles of port, and, you know, pop the cork, right? The people in the Silicon Valley would love this analogy. Not that any of them are listening to this. I doubt there's a single person in the Silicon Valley that is listening to these videos, okay? Sincerely doubt it. And they don't have that much sense, good sense. As a matter of fact, there's probably not that many people in the United States listening. It seems to be that there's the people in the rest of the world have more common sense than the United people in the United States at this point. You know, that is true, isn't it? This place here is the belly of the beast of materialism. And the people here have been targeted and they've just been sabotaged to an extreme extent. Have pity on them. Have mercy on the population of the United States. Really, don't judge us too harshly. We're very good people, actually. Really outstanding. It's been an outstanding country. And outstanding character and outstanding people. But it, because of that, there's been this extra effort to sabotage it. And, you know, it's just like a strong, magnificent bull. They put it in the bull ring. And before you know it, you know, eventually it's on its knees, right? It's like this. So, you know, again, I just ask the people of the world, don't be too harsh on us. Have some pity and some mercy and some compassion, because we're messed up. This country's really messed up, and the people are really messed up. You know, eventually they'll, you know, bounce back, but who knows how far down the line, right? Right, the way things are right now, I'm not going to even speculate on that. You know, Buddha mind is awake mind. It's wakefulness. So we're already that. Everyone's already that. We're all Buddha mind. We're all Buddhas already. We're all Bodhisattvas, right? This instant, we're all that. It's just we're trying to forget this. We're trying to forget that we are. And so, you know, some of us are like saying, yeah, I'm tired of forgetting what I am, so I'm going to stop doing that. And so then they start, you know, to recognize, oh, this is what I am. And share their confidence with you. So that's all I can do. All I can do is share my confidence with everyone. I'm confident. I'm very confident that I'm going to, you know, accept Buddha mind. Very confident. Longchampa said it's a done deal. He guarantees it. He guaranteed it. And I go, oh, my gosh, well, yeah. I will, just as you will, but I may do it, you know, not too far, you know, down the road. Well, I don't know. I'm not going to measure it. I just keep working at it. But I do have this tremendous confidence in the gurus and what they say is true, and that awakening, the accepting inherent wakefulness is something we can all do, and we will all do it. There's no question about it. But no matter how good I sing, I can't quite sing like Jones. Right? So you got those who are, Buddha mind, but they're not quite like Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma. She's quite extraordinary. She said that everything that's happening is, she's aware of everything that's happening in all realms. It's all present in her mind. I just can't quite relate to that yet. And she's responding in many different realms at the same time to all sorts of stuff, not just here, but all over. Helping like a sister, a good sister helping her siblings out. You know how helpful a good sister can be, right? They're fabulous. Really fabulous. So let's see one another, sisters and brothers here, as one family here, and let's knock off this mother thing. This heavy-handed sort of sisters taking the mother role too seriously, like the feminists, radical feminists, and the feminists. It's too much motherness and domination. And a good sister doesn't do that. Now she knows when to back off, and she's helped, and now she's your sister again. You're back on your feet. You change your diaper. Okay, now you're good to go. She doesn't then stops the mother trip on you. Okay, she stops it. She drops it. So, drop the mother trip in the world. It's so important to drop this mother trip. Which is why we don't want Hillary Clinton president. She has this big mother trip on everybody, big time. That's not what we want. It's not what we want. Power goes to your head, unfortunately, in this world, doesn't it? And, there's gurus around that do the mother thing, and no, we don't want that. We want the sister thing. We want the brother thing. We want the brother thing. We want the sister thing. That doesn't mean if your brother or sister is like singing like Jones that you don't go quiet. Of course you do. Remember, Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma is our sister. So, yeah. But if you can handle that, I feel I can handle that. That this is my sister. Wow. Just let that sink in. This is my sister. This isn't some distant mother guru goddess of the universe coming just to give you a benediction and then leave. No. She said, do not see me that way. That is not what I am. I am your sister. I'll always be your sister. We're inseparable. So let that sink into your deep, 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 deep acceptance. And Jesus is our brother. He most certainly is. So this is a very important meditation to do this. You do hear people chanting this and chanting that, but this one is more important. This is a fact. This is an existential, intrinsic fact, you might say, that we can never separate from our sister. She's our sister forever. Jesus is our brother forever. So we better start getting used to them. Don't play this game of questions. I don't understand what you said. What does that have to do with it? She's our sister. This is my sister. And my sister has paid me visits. She comes and visits me. When I ask her to come visit me, I like to do it on demand. She has her own ways. I can't call room service, you know, doesn't seem to quite, but sometimes she shows up, comes and visits me. It's like, wow, you know, don't go away. Now, this brings something up. The fact is she never went away. Where can your sister go? How can your sister leave you, actually? What it was, it is in India, they wanted her to conform to the natural lifestyle of what they think is life, birth, you know, growing up, aging gracefully, and then getting old and finally dying. They asked her to do that for them because they felt more comfortable if she did that. So she said, "That's no problem. Yeah, you can put my bones in rock salt and Kangal, but guess what? To some others, different story. Different story." I've told this story several times before. Whatever devotees who really got it, saw her, suddenly saw her as just this perfectly young body, flawlessly healthy, you know, nothing wrong, just perfect health, flawless. And he saw this for a long time. And then he told her about it. I said, "Hey, you know, which one are you?" And then she explained, "Well, they want to see this body aging and dying, so it's just an appearance, so that this is what their perception is appearing. But for you don't ask that of me, so you perceive me as I truly am, is deathless, you know, flawless." So our perception is very tricky. Perception is really a blindness. It's not seeing, actually, and we choose the things we don't want to see. So they didn't want to see her not aging. They didn't want to see her not dying. So an appearance aged and died, but the real Anand, Sri Sri Anand Mai Ma, didn't die. Okay, didn't die at all. Just this is, or just this appearance of a body dying, actually. So the real Sri Sri Anand Mai Ma never left this world. Ne never vanished from this world. She's been here the entire time. And I said, "Well, how come I can't see you?" You know, just, "Well, you know, it might shock you. So I've been working on this for a long time." Like, wow, yeah. She never left, never left. It's just everybody wants to believe that she left, like, 'cause they want to believe that this is life. That these bodies are life. Bodies have nothing to do with life. The search for life has nothing to do with life, actually. Zero. Absolutely nothing. This is an absurdity. We're not bodies at all. Bodies have nothing to do with what we are. They're just these absurd symbols for, you know, as for the searcher. That's all. And they're terrible. Men and women are terrible, aren't they? They certainly are. Why do we need to love bodies and personalities? We don't. We don't have to. It's a horrible search. The search is a nightmare. It's vicious, isn't it? Very vicious from both sides. Don't ever think that that men are good or women are good. They're both vicious. They're both terrible. But they have nothing to do with what we are. Absolutely nothing to do with it. So it doesn't matter. We can say this. It doesn't affect us at all. It's the truth, though, isn't it? It's really horrible. This search is really a fearful, nasty, desperate search. All confused, all absurd, just crazy. It's an insane asylum, as Sri Sri Nandamai Ma said. This the world is literally an insane asylum. It's a lunatic asylum. This is very true. We're all lunatics here. Those who have evaporated a lot of continuity fear, not quite as much. Not quite as much. But most here are raving lunatics. And that's just, don't blame the body. The body's just a puppet. But certainly, let's not get attached to bodies here. get attached to your practice. Love your practice. Don't love bodies and personalities. Love your practice. There's nothing to love with bodies or personalities. The special relationship is terrible. Jesus says the worst thing is the most vicious defense of all, he says. It's the worst egoic defense of all is the special relationship. So love your practice. Get attached to your practice. Don't bother trying to have bodies like you or, you know, whatever with bodies and people. Forget it. Forget people. They're terrible. They're vicious. They're terrible. They really are terrible. Don't expect anything from people. Just expect success from your practice, because that will give you success. Your practice is what gives you success. Not any special relationship with any person. Not at all. And hopefully I'm being iconoclastic enough here. So you're like, wow, that's very surprising. Very surprised is like another term for like, wow. I hear anybody saying that. Wow, what's going on? Well, you're just wowing your awakening is what it is. And it's not really awakening. You're just wowing the fact that you can't be other than awake. There's nothing but wakefulness. There's only wakefulness. There's only eternal life. This whole thing about impermanence of Buddhism is not quite clear. Actually, that's an illusion. Impermanence is the illusion. So they see through this illusion of impermanence and recognize what's going on. It's not that everything is impermanent. In fact, nothing's impermanent. Everything's eternal. Everything we see is absolutely eternal. But there's an illusion of impermanence, so we're trying. This helps us forget reality, become defamiliar with it. So the way things are set up in these realms of delusion is this mirage of impermanence taking place. It's a mirage of impermanence. All is eternal. There's only eternal life. There's nothing other than that, and we are it. So we've said a lot of things already in this video. I'll keep working on Take Satsang and make it better. It's a lot of work. I've got so many irons in the fire. I've got to keep this taping going. And a lot of people don't like Facebook. But if you just use it in this way, it's actually helpful. It really is. If you get the certain key sites and you're getting the feed from them, on your timeline, and every day you wake up and you go through these pictures. I mean, it's like a spiritual cup of coffee in the morning. It gets you going. It gets you pumped up. Pump it up. Pump it up. Power shift. Here we go. Yeah. So we need that spiritual cup of coffee in the morning and the evening and to keep us going. And that's a great way actually to do it. It's really very effective. And I've highlighted a couple sites, Ram Maharshi and Hammers of Nisargadatta Maharaj. And there's some others, you know, you might like that can give you a newsfeed. Carol Grayson, she gives pictures of Sri Sri Anandamaya Ma. She's done a fabulous, fabulous job. It's super helpful. Thank you very much, Carol. Keep up the great work. We all, you know, it's all greatly appreciated. And she posts a lot of very good quotes and pictures from Sri Sri Anandamaya Ma that are just, you know, it's just fabulous. So you can like her page, Carol Grayson, G-R-A-Y-S-O-N, K-A-R-O-L. I'm sorry, C-A-R-O-L. What am I thinking? C-A-R-O-L. Grayson. And, you know, Punjaji may have a website, and Nyingma Masters, N-Y-I-N-G-M-A Masters, is a very nice site that they post, because Ramana is just extraordinary. The people who run Ramana just do unbelievably great job. They just pump it out every single morning. Same with Hammers of Nisargadatta Maharaj. Every morning they're pumping out pictures and quotes. I take my hat off to them, you know. I really do. If I could stay up 24/7, I would, and I'd be pumping it out too. Of course, I'm pumping out these, you know, 2.5 hours of video every day, along with everything else, plus working 8 hours a day, and taking care of all sorts of helping people and stuff. So, I pump it out pretty good. Also, trying, but I want to do better, of course, a lot better. We should all try to do a lot better. Don't be timid in terms of, you know what, I'm going to go for it. Don't be timid. Nobody's going to, you know, judge you. In fact, we'll applaud you. You stumble, you know, you have, sure, so what? So what? When I started running stairs, I could hardly do anything. I did it just one time, and my legs were like, I said, I can't even walk. This is crazy. This is insane. I can't do this. Now I could do it 5 times and walk away like a champ. It's amazing what's happened. Just amazing. I'm getting some pretty strong legs. They look bigger than before. There's no question about it. My legs are like beefier. It looks like I've got some legs now. You know, like, whoa. What happened to my legs? They get muscles. They get muscles in your legs. I got muscles in my legs. Got all the spinach that I eat. I got to get some kale. I got to start drinking kale smoothies again. I've got that kale in the system for August time. You know. So with I'm going heavy on the fruit. It keeps you very light in terms of your how you feel. Stay away from the heavy stuff. I always do. Stay away, if you're a meat eater, stay away from the heavy meats. Stay away from it, you know, as much as possible. Just try to go with soy if you can, and fruits and vegetables, and whey, you know, yogurt, whey protein, cheese. I eat that stuff, you know, some crackers, some nuts, a lot of nuts I eat. But mostly I'm trying to go, you know, fruits, bananas, eat bananas. Bananas are very good for you. And just detox your system, Just give yourself a chance. Give yourself a chance. What do you have to lose? Why not? I mean, you really want to take birth again and go through all this growing up and all this stuff again and not have momentum? Why not start your momentum right now? What do you have to lose? Basically, you know, catastrophe's coming. You might as well go for it. What do you have to lose? This is the thing. Just tell yourself, wait a minute. I don't want to miss this. I don't want to miss it. I don't want to miss it. I don't want to miss this opportunity. Just tell yourself, I don't want to miss this. I'm not going to miss this. Even if everyone else in the world misses it, I'm not going to miss it. This should be your attitude. And this is pretty much what's happening, really. I mean, if you don't miss it, well, you'll be one of the few, because most everyone in the world will miss it. But be one of those few who doesn't miss it. Why not? Why not discipline yourself? Why not keep those good habits going? Boycott this, boycott that. I boycott so much stuff. Just about boycott the entire world, actually. And it's super helpful. Super helpful. Put your attention on the Dharma kings now. Those ones that really can sing the song. The toppermost. Let the ones who sing it best. Put your attention on them and just keep it there and see what happens. I guarantee you that you will look back and just say, wow, that was extraordinary. Just extraordinary. So don't be afraid to be extraordinary. You won't really stand out that much because everybody's robots don't even know, you know, can't even value extraordinariness at all. To them, you're just another robot, actually. Robots think everyone else are robots. So you won't, you won't really stand out too much in the world. Don't be afraid of that. If you're really outstanding, not many people even notice it, actually. Very few, probably. Look at that Sri Sri Nandamayama. You know, there's the core group of devotees that pay attention to her, but most of the world is completely oblivious of her. Completely oblivious. Isn't that extraordinary? How is that possible? This is our very own self here in the world saying, here I am. You know, this is what you are. And we all ignore it. Said, no, I gotta search for you. I haven't found you yet. So go away. I'm still searching for you. It really means the search is just a cover for our attempt to forget what we are. Okay. So if you think I'm on fire right now, you should have seen earlier in the day. Man, it was a lot of laughter, bursting out in laughter, singing like a bird. You know, I had wings today. I absolutely had wings. I didn't sleep hardly at all last night. Maybe I'm punch drunk. I don't know. I can't sleep anymore. I'm so nervous. Trouble's coming. Trouble's coming. Oh, well, the Olympics start today, right? Boycott the Olympics. Don't watch the Olympics. I'm not watching a second of it, actually. Not even a second. Are you kidding me? This is the most crucial time in history. I'm going to decide, you know, what song I'm going to listen to right now. I'm going to listen to the best songs right now, okay? Some other time, maybe I'll listen to some other songs. But right now, I'm just going to listen to the best songs. That's it. Maybe I'll make a list, a literal list of songs. Shutdown will be on there by the Beach Boys, no question. Man, that song gets you going. George Jones, of course, would just make a list of his songs and then that's it. But yeah, we got to really listen to the best songs, spiritually, I mean, of course. But if you're going to listen to some music literally, just listen to the very best right now, the very best, stuff that just knocks you out. Not to say, oh, that's nice music. No, no, no. So let me just go silent. Just say, can't touch that. Can't touch that. And we have some artists here, the viewers, friends of this program here, that are knockout artists in their own right, don't we? We have some, you know, those working on, you know, some games, video games. We have those doing graphics, and we have those doing poetry. These are knockout artists, okay? So we have some knockout artists here. So keep that going. Keep knocking. I'd like to share that on Take Sat Song if I can, because this is knockout stuff. This is what we need. So those who have that extra something, and we have a number of them here that are extraordinary, actually. I can tell. Right? It's easy for me to tell. They're knockout artists. So we want to share that on Take Sat Song so everybody can get a chance to be knocked out by it, you know. That's what I would like. And so everybody, you know, if you're knockout artist, let's hear it, let's hear it, and share, contribute. Let people attract. This is the time that we're calling for all recruits at this time. We're calling for all recruits to absolutely go all in, and you know, just do a power shift and just power shift right through September 6th, and then we'll take it from there. Won't we? Facebook is a funny place. I'm having trouble. I have to catch the vibe, and the vibe is like still pictures. They like still pictures with quotes. They don't like slideshows. They don't like GIFs. It's something about, they like to go click, 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 click. They're very quick. You know, like I put new pictures up and like. So they must be taking like 1 second with the picture, basically. Seriously. There's some people just like, they see something, they like it, they hit the like, and they like doing that. That's fine. It's encouraging. But people don't take time anymore. They don't spend any time actually on Facebook. You know, 10 seconds probably is like about as much as anyone spends on any picture probably or anything else. It's click, 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 tap, 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 tap. And of course, they think they're tripping the light fantastic by doing that. So this is, you know, it's real tough, because my thing is you got to immerse yourself in the wow. You've got to get to the wow. Maybe that's just their way of doing it. So, you know, I can't change it. I put up a slideshow and people just, you know, they're not going to spend more than 10 seconds on anything you post. So why spend so much time on it? This is another, you know, tough thing. And you get caught up in that. Like, oh yeah, okay, it's Ramana. Great. Like, next one. Right? It's ridiculous. what do you do? I mean, what a crazy world it is right now, isn't it? but you can't succumb to the craziness. You have to get it anyway. And it does sink in. You spend time with pictures of Sri Sri Nana Maima, it's going to have a powerful effect on you, even if you're doing it fast. It's like super bodhicitta for you. It's just so strong. It absolutely gives you confidence in your own realization that I don't need to awaken. I've never been asleep. I am intrinsically awake. I'm wakefulness. Buddha mind is wakeful mind. Buddha mind is wakeful mind. Buddha mind is wakeful mind. Without doing anything. You can never make it anything other than that. So you got nothing to do but abidance. There's nothing to do but abidance. Nothing else to do whatsoever. Everything else is a search, no matter how we configure it. Everything else is a search for what we already are. Nothing more than that. We put it in good and bad and conflict, good and bad. No, that's just a search. That's all it is. We're trying to disguise it. Say, no, we're getting rid of this bad, and then we'll try it. No, it's a search, which means you're trying to forget what you are. Whatever you're doing, if you're not aware of abidance, you're trying to forget abidance. No matter what. So, this is something the gurus bring to you, and you feel it. It's like, wow, I'm not quite getting it. I'm still forgetting what I am, but I feel so attracted to not forgetting anymore. They attract us to not forgetting, right? We're dropping the forgetfulness, dropping the search. They attract us to that. So we just have to keep allowing ourselves to be attracted to this. And it works. So I haven't been working out until today. I was just so exhausted from the trip from Wauchella and tired, gained weight, and I think I'm going to lose it here in August. But today I went out and I did some jump rope, lifted some weight, and broke the spell. And now I'm feeling back into it a lot more. Did some stretching. I had to really kind of pump it up in my mind and break the spell, break the inertia. So you may have to do that spiritually. You may just have to break the inertia. Just do it. Just break the inertia, and be on fire, be on spiritual fire, because the world's going to be on fire pretty soon. Actually, it most certainly is. This is part of what's coming in the world. The spirit of lawlessness is upon the land, as it has been in days gone by. And when that catches hold, it's burn, baby, burn. You went through the 60s. I mean, remember Watts? I mean, Malcolm X, burn, baby, burn. And I believe it was him. And, there are various... they burned Watts down, basically, right? But when you get into that burn, baby, burn mode, and it catches on like wildfire, it happens. It happens. It happens. Don't think it can't happen. Seriously. California's been burning. Quote unquote, campers, left their campfires, started a fire. Well, kind of stupid campers, huh? Maybe they left their campfire on purpose. Okay. So the whole state is full of smoke. And in my dreams, I've been shown that the characteristic of what's coming in the world is it looks extremely dusty, extremely hazy. The atmosphere is full of what I thought was dust, but smoke. Smoke is dust, isn't it? It's cinders, small little particles of dust. And people could hardly see or do anything. It was so smoky. So that could be spiritual. It could be subtle fires of emotional fires taking place, which produces an emotional haze in the world. The haze could be emotional, could be mental, it could also be physical. So there's going to be a massive amount of haze in our spiritual psyche coming up, a horrible haze, purple haze, it was in my mind. don't know if this is the end of times, like that. Jimi Hendrix was sort of a prophet. He was very, very interesting. Very iconoclastic, Jimi Hendrix. Excuse me while I touch the sky. Yeah, excuse me as I touch the sky. A sky of what? True nature, intrinsic spaciousness. Buddha mind, wakeful mind. Excuse me as I touch wakeful mind. Because this purple haze is, you know, it's just in my mind. It's everywhere. Excuse me while I touch the sky. Do, 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 do. Boom, boom. I haven't listened to that for quite some time. Wow. Another one by Jimi Hendrix. Great one is All on the Watchtower. Holy cow. Those are two should be on our list. Those are knockouts. Can't Find My Way Home. Stevie Winwood. Eric Clapton. That's a knockout song there. There are certain songs that just be quiet. You just quiet and just say, wow. Everybody has their favorites. Of course, that's understood. George Jones. These days, I barely get by. I just don't give a damn. Another one song. I just don't give a damn. Wow. So many by Jones. So many that just. Man, you just feel something. Hard times, you know, hard times. You feel it. It's coming. Hazy times. Purple haze is coming. Mental, emotional, physical. It's coming. Very, very soon. So we need our spiritual oxygen mask. Like we're in an airplane, the oxygen mask drops down. You know, the smoke, the plane is full of smoke. You put your oxygen mask on, right? So we need spiritual oxygen mask right now, actually. So all of you who can contribute your spiritual oxygen, you know, do so. Offer to do so and say, hey, I've got something. Let's circulate it here. Circulate. Haribo, 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 Haribo. And again, Facebook, they don't pay. If you put audio on their video, no. They want pictures. They want a 10-second buzz, a hit. They want a, yeah, pow. Little fairy, stardust. We are stardust. We are golden. We got to get back. Yeah, Crosby, Stills, and Nash. That's another great song. Back to the garden. Da, 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 da. Yeah, wow. If I had a good microphone, I'd do a little human jukebox. I'd be listening to the songs on my headphones. I'd put them on YouTube and I could sing along with them. But I'm outside. It's, how late is it? 9 o'clock. Gotta belt it out. You can't sing sotto voce. It sounds terrible. So when I'm in a vehicle, all the windows up, driving on the freeway, you know, I can sing as loud as I want to sing. And that's where, you know, it smooths out when you sing loud. But this microphone here, holy cow, no, it's just for talking real soft like this. It's not a singing microphone. Yeah, I need a Neumann. Come on, was it N57 or 47? Tube Neumann. Oh man, made your voice sound like syrup and butter. Put it in a reverb chamber, echo chamber. Ridiculous. I heard a song Jones doing live with no dry, completely dry. Everything was dry. Their instruments, his voice, totally dry. It was still sounded great, but you could just tell the difference of the studio when you tweak it up with all the compression and the echo chamber and various EQing and stuff. Oh, man. It just sort of puts icing on the cake. He's got chocolate cake. It's good, but put the icing on it. You know, it's like, it's great. Boy, I'd like to get this entertainer down there in Palm Springs who was playing, you know, if we ever have some gatherings to play for us, you know, he's like really good, very, very talented, could sing all those great songs from the 60s and 70s, you know, he just has this massive repertoire of these songs, and it's just, he sang this Eagle song, you know, it was great. You, oh, what was it? You can't hide your lion eyes or something like that. Yeah. Well, you could do Tequila Sunrise. The Eagles were a pretty cool band. I think that was an LA band. A lot of great bands came out of LA, a lot of great music. So we're cooking through here. We've gone about an hour and a half. All right, so gotta hammer it somehow, huh? I think I found a way to start doing some Facebook, better way to do it, actually. Or one way to do it. So don't back down. Don't back down, Beach Boys. Don't back down. Don't back down. Another great song. And I'll put that on the list. Get you pumped up. Don't back down from the challenge. Let your colors fly. That's another one. Be true to your school. Let your colors fly. This is no time to go into a shell, folks. It's no time to go into some shell at all. It's time to let it go, you know, let it go. 360 degree. And yeah, most people won't salute. You put up the flag, nobody salutes. Guess what? Just double down and go, let it go even more. Within your own iconoclastic wisdom, be iconoclast, real true one. You have to be very wise and read the room and you know, you're not some sort of whatever the word is, right? You know, it's full of grace. It's full of grace and humor, high humor, and it flows. But you're always, you know, you're surfing a wave, but it's under control. You know, you have it under control. I'm singing in the car. I'm gesturing as I'm moving, and you know, pump it up and make, you know, just all the stuff. Just wow. You know, people look at me like, what's wrong with this guy? But you know, I step out of the car and I'm, you know, Joe Normal. Because I'm not losing it, you know. I'm enthusiastic. I understand the situation. It's okay to do that when, you know, you're in traffic and you're going nowhere. Yeah, going nowhere, you're going like 2 miles an hour, you know. Let's sing some Jones. Come on. Pump it up. And you know, you just wow. Just wow it. You know, wow. You can make some gestures. Make a few gestures, for God's sake, you know. Do a little, as you're walking, just a little skipping, you know, just, yeah. Just a little thing. I mean, it's like a second or a half second. You just put a little hitch in your giddy up and just, like, feel like, I'm smoothing it out. You know, I'm just, I do that. I put a little move as I'm walking along, just like Joe Normal, and then just a little hop. I might do just a little bird hop or something. A little bird hop and then, you know, or just, yeah. If you see somebody, give them a thumbs up. Give them two thumbs up. You know, hey, two thumbs up, yeah. And you know, try to be a little more expressive of your own, you know, idiosyncratic, iconoclastic, you know, non-robotic spiritual nature. You know, difference is you don't go out and get drunk and make an idiot out of yourself, right? Hey, I'm being really iconoclastic. I did this. No. We're as sober can be. We're the most sober people in the world, actually. That doesn't mean that you're drag, you know, just like a robot in a robot. No, in fact, you're even more expressive. In terms of subtle gestures, you can be subtly iconoclastic. To roboticism and to everything that is, you know, searchness, yeah. My back started hurting again, finally. It hadn't been hurting for quite some time. I don't know what I did. Probably lifting weights. I think that may do it. Stop lifting weights, and it seems to go away. I stopped for a while, and it went away. I don't know. That may be it. Or swinging the golf club. I did that today. I could bring it back. I don't need that actually. Not playing golf. I don't know if I should or not. I think it's this is you know, just have to crush this month, don't we? The next week, next 30 days, 31 days, just crush it. Just start today. Just be in the mood. Be in the mood. Will yourself to be in the mood. Will yourself to be in the mood. Will yourself to be in the mood. Don't caffeine yourself to get in the mood, because you'll tail off and you'll stall out. You'll stall out. There's a called caffeine, the stall out drug. That's what it is, because it gives an illusion of progress. Illusion. You're almost there. You're almost there. Almost. I'm really good. Oh, but I didn't quite make it. Stalls you out. It's custom designed to stall you out, actually. And the ego loves it. It's the favorite drug of the ego, caffeine, because the ego knows this is a stall out drug. This is what it does. And you will think that you're gonna wow, I'm really world beater right now. I'm really doing it, doing it, doing it, doing it, doing it. And then, oh, you know, I didn't quite make it. And the ego says, oh, that's too bad. You know, maybe that stuff's all kind of like fairy tale stuff, you know. That's why you don't really need that. Yet. And then starts rationalize it for you, and then you grab a hold of the rationalization, and say, "Oh yeah, it makes me feel better." Yeah. Oh yeah, they're idiots. Yeah, I can see now that they're idiots. So you end up, you stall out, and then you rationalize your stall out with caffeine. This is what happens: stall out, rationalize your stall out. I've said this, you know, 1,000 times. Still true. Still true. So today, I was super tired this morning, just exhausted. I thought, man, you know what, caffeine would really help me today. It would really help me. But I said no. I did eat a little bit of chocolate, just regular chocolate. Probably helped me a little bit, but it's not quite, you know, it's not quite the trouble of caffeine. But not even close, actually. If you eat too much, chocolate can do. I didn't eat that much. But it's probably best to stay away from chocolate as well. But you know, you can be higher than caffeine, really, but in a smooth, graceful, subtle way, without no caffeine at all. I'm not using caffeine. I'm able to be flying high like this, and yet be completely conventional at an instant, no, instant notice, without any jarringness or paranoia or anything. All right? If you try to force something on caffeine, oh my God, I think I'm, you know, too much. Okay, let me, how do I tone it? How do I tone it down? And then you start struggling and forcing and thinking, right, am I too much? Paranoia creeps in. Paranoia is a side effect of drugs. It's terrible, isn't it? Stay away from drugs. It most certainly is. I don't have paranoia like that. I do not. I have an instant notice. I can just drop it, and people realize that. I become totally conventional instantly, and if they look at me like, "Oh, that guy's kind of a, that's kind of kooky," what you do? And then boom, I'm normal. And then they just like, "Oh, okay, it's fine." You know, they don't doesn't freak them out or anything like that, really. No, because they kind of just, they just, you know, oh, okay, you know, he was just kind of a little kooky there, and but now he's fine. So as long as you're functioning in the way that they expect when you're dealing with them, people are okay. They're okay with that, basically. Most are. There's a few brittle ones around. Yeah, there are. Women and men. There's some brittle ones, so you have to steer clear of those and read the room, right? But I, you know, so I just, I just be idiosyncratic and iconoclastic, and yourself, you know, just be awakening mindness in the flow that feels right for you. You just have to monitor it yourself. They don't come to people and say, "Hey, people, I'm in the flow." Well, if that feels good to you, you can do that. And a lot of times now, I'm just like, you know, I'm just clapping my hands, just okay. Here we go. Yeah, like that. Here we go. A nice clap is like really helpful, just centers you. Okay. Bam. Just like that. So you could do that. You're just driving your car and just go boom for a second, and then you're back on the steering wheel like that. just like that, it'll your mind will say, oh yeah, time to pump it up here. Pump up the volume. And we've gotten so much help through the decades, haven't we? Just in little ways. You know, artists, musicians, they sneak a little bit in there. Even the priests sneak a little bit in there. But they usually get caught, get their knuckles wrapped. The nuns wrap their knuckles, probably. artists, they sneak a little bit, pump it up. Come on, let's pump it up. Let's pump it up. But in a sober way, in a very sober way. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Gotta be cool now. Power shift. Here we go. Wow.